So whom do we thank? It's the British chemist Sir Humphrey Davy, and it was an accidental invention. Let's study it more. So in 1799, he was working in the laboratory and was studying the behavior of gases. On a whim, he inhaled nitrous oxide and found that the gas made him lighthearted and had strange sensation on his nose. He believed that the gas had euphoric and analgesic quality and named it laughing gas. Davy was curious by his discovery. He began to experiment it on himself and on his close friends, including the poet Samuel Taylor Coleridge. He suggested that his laughing gas had a numbing effect and could be useful in surgeries to ease pain. However, it would need several decades till his discovery became a common practice. On 38 March 1842, an American surgeon and pharmacist, Crawford W. Long, used ether as an anesthetic in a surgery to remove a tumor from a patient's neck. Not only nitrous oxide, but ether is also used as an anesthetic. Then he discovered that ether had same effect that nitrous oxide had on patients. So then he experimented it on a patient using ether as an anesthetic, and it was a success. Then in 1845, he administered inhaled ether on his wife Caroline Swain during childbirth. So as he succeeded two times, he started using ether during amputation and subsequent surgeries, and also promoted the use of ether. But Crawford Long did not file a patent, and his results were not documented or published until much later in 1849. Still, he didn't receive his due credit due to ether controversy. And now let's look into the next part of the story by introducing William Thomas Green Morton. Morton learned the use of ether as an anesthetic in a lecture at Harvard Medical School. He left medical school and started practice as a dentist. Then he successfully used ether in a tooth extraction, which gained him publicity and caught the attention of Henry Jacob Bigelow, a professor of surgery at Harvard University. Professor Bigelow arranged for Morton to give a live demonstration of the use of substance. After his successful live demonstration, Morton filed a patent for ether, which he labeled as lethon. The operating theater where Morton made his demonstration came to be called the Ether Dome. But fortune wasn't taking the side of Morton. What happened? What is ether controversy? Let's learn it in the next video. Until then, bye!